Happy Saturday. Nancy Burt Priest here, an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. And today I want to showcase some of the products on page 108 and 109 of your old catalog, because the new one's not quite out yet. And it's the Forever Greenery Suite. And we're going to focus on a couple of the products. Some are the Forever Greenery Designer Series paper, which I love. The embossing folders, we're going to use one of these, which are called greenery embossing folders. And if you have a smaller machine, they work well with that. And of course, the Forever Fern bundle, which includes this Forever Fern stamp set, which I love, love, love. And it also includes these wonderful dies, which is Forever Flourishing dies. And you get like a whole bunch of them. I haven't put this on a sheet yet, which I should. It's a mess. But I usually put them on a magnetic sheet. This one I haven't gotten to. But it has all these wonderful dies. And I think I showed you on my Wednesday video this one, because it's one of my favorites. I use it a lot, and I love it. So let me show you a few of the projects I made with this wonderful suite. So let me close this up and show you the first one. And I cased this, and now I can't remember who I cased it from. I will try to put that in the comments. This is a nice one because, oops, I see one of my little things fell off. I'm always touching them and they fall off. But what this is just using the DSP. It's cut at 1x5, these two parts. This one is 4x3. These are 1x2 3/8, I'm pretty sure. I'll have that in your directions if you get a kit from me. And I just stamped to a friend that makes me smile on the inside. So you just use one of the stamps. I use this in Pretty Peacock. A simple card, and there will be a third little gold one. Don't worry, I give you lots of them in your kit, so if one falls off, you got more. In fact, I just found where this one is sneaking, and I had it right here. Just add that little three. Your eye likes things in three. So very simple card, and once again, I'll put in the comments who I cased this from. Just fun and easy. That's our first card. Second card, I cased this from Flutter by Heidi, who is from the UK, and I tweaked it up a little bit, but I really loved that she used unconventional colors. So what she did is she used Blushing Bride, Smoky Slate, and then our Basic White. And she just, I used the sentiments I'm using are all from this Forever Fern set, and you can do this as a nice sentiment. And I cut out this piece using one of the flourishing dies, and I trimmed the bottom off before I put it down because I didn't want it to show underneath. So if you get one of these, you might want to trim the bottom off. I glued that down. I glued the two other parts that I gave you some. If you got a kit from me, you got some white that you can stamp these in a gray and then cut them out with your dies. I stamped these with Blushing Bride or a pink that you have. Cut them out with your dies. I just used that little speckle image. I love speckles. And I stamped off and stamped it all over here in the Smoky Slate. The saying is in Smoky Slate. I have some, these are the silver metallic pearls. On this one, we use the gold metallic pearls. So these are the silver. And then I just tied a little bit of this white polka dot ribbon on there. And I just thought it's such a pretty card. I did pop these up. These were all flat. This is flat, but I did pop these up. So simple, but another fun card. My third card, I'm using the Stitched Shapes dies, which are retiring and I'm very sad about. So make sure if you like those, get those before they go out of the catalog. And what I did is this is where I used one of those greenery embossing folders. And I put it in so I'd get a little bit on the top and the bottom, which I think is really kind of neat personally. And then I attached it to my mint macaron. And then I have this as your mint macaron, and I popped this little piece up. And what I used is I just used a bunch of the leaf images, and I used greens that I liked. I used the mint macaron, just jade, and garden green. And then I used the seine. I gave you some of this mint, and I just stamped the seine in pretty peacock, or you could do it in black, and I just cut it out. That's me cutting it out. There is no die for that. I just cut around it. I used some of those wonderful, you know, I keep using those holiday gems all the time. So I used a couple of the holiday gems, and I just stamped a little bit inside. So that's a fun, different card. And then the final card we're going to do today, I'll show it to you first, and then I'll show you how we're going to make it. So here's, it's an accordion fold. And it opens like this. Isn't that cool? My friend Sally Fritz showed me hers, and she got the directions from Linda Bowen, who got the directions from one of her customers. So it's, I'm not exactly sure who the very first person is, but here's what the directions are. So the back is just a single sheet of pear pizzazz, and it is 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And then you take a piece of 5 1/4 by 12 of your DSP. Now I found I was trying to do DSP like this, and I mean, this is okay, but I don't really like that it's all oriented that way. I should have cut it, you know, it didn't work. So I decided I liked it when it was a little bit more, you know, it could go any directional. And the first thing I did is I cut it, I scored it at 4 8 inches. Then I'm going to turn it over, and I'm going to, I always do it oriented up, and I'm going to mark a little mark at the 2 1/2 inch mark right here. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna orient this. Hopefully you can see this on camera. This is what Linda did, and it was such a great idea. As you orient and you put that in the top of your cutting track, and you can move this up a little bit so it's off. And then you're gonna orient the bottom so it's in the cutting track. So this little mark and the bottom. Make sure I got that again. And I would save this piece I cut off. You might use it for different things, little strips on the bottom of cards. Lots of things you can do with that extra. So now you have your fold. And depending on how you want it to look, you can fold it different ways. I've seen her do it like this, if you want this side out, or you can fold it like this, if you want that side out. That's the side I like out, but you know, you get to decide what it is you really like. So the next thing, so that's that. Then I used some of the dies in Pear Pizzazz and cut out some little doodads. I also used the Love and Laughter Forever and After, as I thought that'd be kind of a really neat wedding card. And then on the inside, this is a piece of basic white, 3 3/4 by 4 1/2. And what she had you do is just mark at the 3/4 mark, put it in your paper cutter and cut it at an angle so it kind of fits nicely. I haven't added specifically any doodads on here, but I'm probably going to give you some gems of your choice if you get a kit from me, so you can add them to your card. So I hope you have enjoyed these cards with the Forever Fern stamp set, Forever Flourishing dies, and some of the wonderful DSP. I hope you have a happy Saturday.